Hello and welcome to this video abstract titled Repetitions in Reserve is a Reliable Tool for Prescribing Resistance Training Load. This is a nice study led by Simon Lovegrove as part of his MSc project in Strength and Conditioning at St Mary's University in London. The study was published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research in 2021. Before we discuss what the researchers did, let's give a little background to the study. Autoregulation-based approaches to resistance training are currently used by researchers and practitioners, potentially offering a superior alternative to traditional prescription strategies, as they account for unpredictable fluctuations in an individual's performance. One novel method of autoregulation involves making load adjustments based on the number of additional repetitions an individual believes that they could complete prior to reaching muscular failure. And this is known as repetitions in reserve. This allows practitioners and athletes to adjust training loads based on their scores given at the conclusion of a set. For example, if an individual has been prescribed a target of 2 repetitions in reserve, yet finished a set with 4 reps in reserve, the load would be increased in the subsequent set. Repetitions in reserve targets of 1 to 4 are commonly recommended, allowing practitioners to prescribe a high training stimulus while avoiding the risks and prolonged post-exercise fatigue associated with training to muscular failure. To date, little is known about the reliability of repetitions in reserve as a load prescription tool. Determining the reliability of repetitions in reserve not only provides a novel method of autoregulation, but allows individuals to periodize training without the need for one repetition max testing. This is especially important for novice and youth populations who may not be comfortable with one repetition max testing. Repetitions in reserve offers an alternative approach. Current evidence suggests that novice lifters are less likely to accurately gauge repetitions in reserve to more experienced lifters, but these studies have all been conducted within a single testing session, where subjects may not have been familiarized with repetitions in reserve protocols. Furthermore, the repetitions in reserve estimates were made following repetitions which were distant to muscular failure. Therefore, the aim of this study was to investigate whether repetitions in reserve can be used as a reliable tool to prescribe load for 2 commonly used exercises, namely the bench press and deadlift, using a 1 repetition in reserve load. So what did they do? Well, 15 male resistance trained novices with less than 6 months resistance training experience took part in the study. They attended the lab on 4 different occasions, each separated by 7 days. Session 1 was used to assess 1 repetition max values for the deadlift and bench press, which was used to determine warm-up loads in subsequent visits. During the remaining visits, they performed multiple sets using 3 different repetition schemes, for example 3, 5 and 8 repetitions. And the order in which each repetition scheme was performed was determined using a random sequence generator. For each repetition scheme, progressive heavier loads were used for each subsequent set until they felt that they had reached a 1 repetition reserve based on the scale by Zordas et al. Of the 3 remaining sessions, session 2 was used to familiarize the subjects to the repetitions in reserve scale and the physical sensations associated with training to different repetitions in reserve values. This anchoring process is important to improve perceptual responses. Sessions 3 and 4 were used to collect data to assess test-retest reliability of the load corresponding to 1 repetition in reserve for each repetition scheme. Between repetition scheme comparisons were also made to ensure load prescription was sensitive to different demands associated with performing different number of repetitions within a set. Mean 1 repetition max for deadlift and bench press were 1.7 times body weight and 0.8 times body weight respectively. For the deadlift, 1 repetition in reserve corresponded to loads of 88%, 84% and 77% for 3, 5 and 8 repetitions respectively. For the bench press, loads of 93%, 87% and 79%, 1 repetition max corresponded to 1 repetition in reserve for 3, 5 and 8 repetitions respectively. The following table represents test-retest reliability of the load corresponding to one repetition in reserve for 3, 5 and 8 repetitions for the deadlift and the bench press sets. All test-retest comparisons demonstrated a high level of reliability. For example, the deadlift interclass correlation coefficient ranged from 0.95 to 0.99 and coefficient of variation from 2.7 to 5.7%. For the bench press, ICCs range from 0.97 to 0.99 and CVs from 3.8 to 6.2%. The main findings of this study indicate that 1. The load corresponding to one repetition in reserve is highly reliable for deadlift and bench press sets comprising the same number of repetitions. And 2. Different loads corresponding to one repetition in reserve in sets which compare different number of repetitions, suggesting that repetitions in reserve can be used as a reliable tool to prescribe load for both the deadlift and bench press. We recommend that practitioners implement the repetitions in reserve based load prescription in a periodized manner by manipulating the number of repetitions to be performed and subsequently load over successive mesocycles. For further videos, follow us on Twitter at Stephen_Pat and St Mary's_Caps.